Good morning, students. Myself Navya, I am your new chemistry teacher. And today's my topic is about periodic table, periodic properties, and variations of the properties in the periodic table. Before going to my topic, I'll give brief introduction about what do you mean by chemistry. Chemistry is nothing but the branch of science which deals with the matter, composition of the matter, chemical equation, chemical balance, atoms, molecules, elements, compounds, periodic table, etc. This is called as chemistry. Chemistry is an interdisciplinary subject where we can find vast amount of knowledge, etc. Now let me go on to the topic about periodic table. Hope so you have studied in your previous classes about this periodic table. Let me say information about the periodic table. A few scientists like Devonier, Newland, Mendeleev, as well as Henry Moseley, who proposed or put forward some statements about this periodic table. Coming to first scientist called as Devonier, according to him, he states that a periodic table is nothing but he grouped the elements in the three triads and he says that the middle one, the atomic weight of middle one, is the arithmetic mean of other two elements. By giving example, I will show how he has been discovered his theory. Example, you take calcium, which has atomic number 20, atomic mass number 40, strontium, that is Sr, 38 and 88, barium, which will be having atomic number as 36 and atomic mass number as 137. According to him, he grouped the elements. These are your elements. Calcium, strontium and barium are your elements. Grouped the elements in the three triads. These are your three triads. He grouped the elements in the three triads in such a way that the atomic weight of this is arithmetic mean of other two. Suppose atomic weight is of strontium is 88. He says that arithmetic mean of other two is equals to this. To take arithmetic mean of calcium and barium, that is 137 plus 40. 137 plus 40 is nothing but 177. When 177 is divided by 2, it comes around 88. You can find the atomic weight of strontium. Hope so you have been understood this Devonian law of periodic table. Next, another scientist by name called as Newland discovered the periodic table. He observed that the elements is in the increasing order of their atomic masses. He states that, or he put forward that he observed the elements which will be increasing order of their atomic masses. And also he states that every eighth element beginning from the any element resembles the first element in its physical and chemical properties. He states that every eighth element which is beginning from the any element resembles the first element in its physical and chemical properties. That is nothing but your eighth element which resembles your first element will be same in its physical as well as chemical properties. See, you are looking, this is your periodic table. Suppose you take 8th element from here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. The properties of Fe, what it will be? It will be identical to that of potassium in its both physical as well as chemical properties. This is about this law, that is nothing but Newland's law. Next, let me pass on to Mendeleev. Mendeleev is nothing, he is one of the scientists. He put forward the periodic table law in such a way that properties of the elements are the periodic functions of their atomic masses. He states that properties of the elements are the periodic functions of their atomic masses. That is nothing but he given the information about the elements' atomic masses. Due to some drawback, this Mendeleev has diminished or he broken his theory. Drawbacks are nothing but he cannot place the rare earth metal as well as isotopes. This is the drawback of Mendeleev periodic table theory. Next, periodic table. Let me move on to modern periodic table. Modern periodic table. In this modern periodic table, which was proposed by Henry Moseley, he states that functions of, he states that the properties of the element, that is nothing but either physical or chemical properties of the element, are the periodic functions, are the periodic functions of their atomic numbers, of their atomic numbers. He states that the period, the properties of, whether it may be physical or chemical properties, these are the periodic functions. These are the periodic functions of atomic numbers, of atomic numbers, atomic numbers. He says that, another one time I will repeat, this Henry Moseley, which is also called as modern periodic table, this, the properties of the periodic functions of their atomic numbers. Properties are nothing but physical as well as chemical property. This is the law of Henry Moseley. He given the modern periodic table. Again, further, he has been classified this modern periodic table into two categories, that is periods as well as groups. Periods as well as groups. See, this is your modern periodic table. He classified this periodic table into periods and groups. Periods are nothing but seven horizontal rows is called as periods. Periods are nothing but seven horizontal rows are called as periods. Groups, 18 vertical columns. Is called as groups. Periods are nothing but 7 horizontal rows are called as periods. Groups are nothing but 18 vertical columns are called as groups. By seeing this periodic table, you will come to know which is period and which is groups. See, suppose horizontal rows 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 horizontal rows are called as periods. If anybody asks you how many periods are there, you should say 7. These are 7 periods. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Next, coming to groups, horizontal vertical columns are called as groups. Listen here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. 18 vertical columns are called as groups. I think you have been understood what is period and what is group. Next, let me move on to classification of periodic table. Classification of periodic table is nothing but, see here, group 1, group 2, until 18 groups you have seen. Group 1, this is called as alkali metals, starting from lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium, cesium, francium. This is called as alkali metals. Next, group 2 elements, beryllium, magnesium, calcium, strontium, barium, and radium. This is called as radium, it is radioactive element, and this is called as alkali earth metals. From group 3 to group 12, these are called as D block elements or transition elements. These are called as D block or transition elements. Next, group 13 is called as boron family, group 14 is called as carbon family, group 15 is called as nitrogen family, group 16 is called as oxygen family, and group 17 elements are called as halogens, and group 18 elements are called as noble gases or inert gases, which shows a different physical as well as chemical properties, and it is highly stable. It does not react with any other elements. This group elements, what you are seeing in the periodic table, it does not react with any other elements because it is highly stable. This is the classification of periodic table. This is the classification of periodic table. Group 1, alkali metals, alkaline earth metal is group 2. From group 3 to group 12, it is called as transition elements or it is called as D block elements. Group 13, boron family, carbon family, nitrogen family, oxygen family. Group 17 are called as halogens, starting from your fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine, etc. And group 18 is called as noble gases or inert gases. Noble gases or inert gases. This is about the periodic table, classification of periodic table and Henry Moseley who have given the periodic table definition. Now you can say, what do you mean by periodic table? Periodic table is nothing but it is a tabular arrangement of an element of a specific atom. It is called as periodic table. Is called as periodic table. Either it has been established based on atomic size, atomic mass number, physical property, chemical property, etc. But according to this modern periodic table, the definition of periodic table states that the elements are the periodic functions of their atomic numbers, that is nothing but the properties, that is physical and chemical properties of the elements are the periodic functions of their atomic numbers. This is about modern periodic table. This is about classification, periods as well as groups. He has been classified this periodic table into periods as well as groups and he has been placed in few atoms. Next coming to classification, I have just said now, 7 periods are there and 18 vertical columns which is called as groups, it is present. Now let me move on to what do you mean by shell as well as valency in order to understand the further topics. Now let me say what do you mean by shell. Shell. A shell is nothing but a nucleus which is present in the center. Suppose you take this as a nucleus which is present in the center and the another orbit. And the another orbit or shell. K shell, N shell, M shell, N shell. And here the electrons are revolving. A shell is nothing but a nucleus which is present at the center. It has a certain number of shells where the electrons will be revolving around it in a definite circular path. Is called a shell. Another one time I will repeat. A center nucleus is present. Around that many shells will be there, like K shell, L shell, M shell, N shell. In this, the electron will be revolving in a definite circular path. This is about shell. You can see K shell, L shell, M shell, N shell. K shell, L shell, M shell, N shell. You should take one formula, 2 into N square. That is equals to, in K shell, 2 into 1 square, that is equals to 2. 2 into 2 square, that is equals to 8. 2 2s are 4, 4 2s are 8. 2 into 3 square, that is nothing but 18. 3 3s are 9, 9 2s are 18. 2 into 4 square, 16 2s are 32. These are the number of electrons which can be present in K shell, L shell, M shell, N shell. K shell can accommodate 2 electrons, L shell can accommodate 8 electrons, M shell can accommodate 18 electrons, N shell can accommodate 32 electrons. This is about shell. In next class, I will say how the electrons will be accommodated according to their electronic configuration. Thank you for watching my video. Thank you.